Hi children, welcome back to your social class. I am the social teacher Ayesha. Children, in previous class we started competing with our the nations, right? We have competed India and the United Nations. Now we are going to start with lesson number 6, our government. Children, everyone take out page number, lesson number 6 and page number 250. Okay, our government. So you know very well, our government, India has how many states and how many union territories? India has at least 28 states. And how many union territories, children? 8 union territories. Earlier, India was having 7 union territories and 29 states. But now Jammu Kashmir has become the union territory. So we have totally 8 union territories and 28 states. Right, children? And to manage all this is very difficult, right? To manage all the states and territories, it's very difficult. So what has the government has done? These 28 states would be run by a government, by the state government. It will be done by the state government. And this union territories will be done by the central government. Who will take care of the states and union territories? States, 28 states will be taken care by state government. And 8 union territories will be taken care by central government. Even we also have, right, when we have CM, we have a governor, we have other minister. But it is meant for the states, 28 states and union territories also by central government. Okay, our country is very large, our country is vast and large. So, state government and central government divide among themselves and they take care of the country. Okay, the central government look after the issues of national importance. State government will take care of the state, central government will take care of the union territories. But central government also has another responsibilities of taking care of issues of national importance. Including states, they will take care of the central territories also, union territories also. The armed forces are under control of central government. Armed forces, army forces and all are there, no? They are the under control of central government. Central government has the authority over army government, that is armed forces. Each state government look after the issues of local importance. For example, our state, Karnataka is our state, right? Okay, our chief minister will take care of the local, our Karnataka's issues are there. Our chief minister, our governor, our other ministers will take care of our state issues. Okay, the police force which protects the life and property is under the state government. Police force are there, right? Police force, they are under the state government. Central government helps the state government when needed. Central government doesn't only take care of armed forces or doesn't only take care of union territories. It even takes care of the state government when the state government need any help. Okay. Both central and state government work together for the welfare of people. Yes, both central as well as state government work will fund for the welfare, for the good of the people itself. They have three major jobs: to make laws, enforce and dispense justice. Three major things they have to do is, one is to make laws. They have to make laws that is good for the citizens. Enforce, they have to enact on this. They have to enact on this and to provide justice. If anything wrong, they have to provide justice also for them. Dispense justice then. Now, what are the state government and what are the central government will run? First of all, what is the central government? Central government are the union government consists of three main parts. Central government or union government consists of three main parts. What are the three, children? One is legislative. In state government, what we have? Sorry, central government, what we have? Legislative. Executive and judiciary. Legislative, executive and judiciary. What is legislative will do? Legislative will make the laws. What is legislative will do? Make laws. What does executives will do? They carry out the Children, all the central government, that is, what is it? There are three main laws. This is legislative, executive, judiciary. Legislative, what does legislative council will do? It will make the laws for the benefit of the people. Okay, legislative council will make the laws for the benefit of people. Executive will carry out whatever the laws they have made. Executive will put it on the, emphasis on the people. It will guide the people what the laws they have made. And judiciary team will look on under the, if everyone should get the justice. Whatever the laws they have made, they will look into that each law, whatever they have made, it should be benefit for people and everyone should get justice for the laws. Okay, children? This comes under the central government. Okay? Then central government of the consists of, what are the central government consists? Central government consists, one is parliament. The president, the prime minister, council of ministers, then we have Supreme Court. Okay, what all the central government will take care of children? So what all will come under the central government, and what central government consists of is, one is the parliament, president, prime minister, council of ministers and supreme court. So central government consists of all this, okay? One is the parliament, president, prime minister, council of ministers as well as supreme court. Now next we are going to start with the parliament, okay? Supreme central government consists of parliament, right? What is parliament? Parliament is a legislative branch. What is legislative, children? The one who makes laws. So parliament is a legislative branch. You can give it term, it is also called as legislative branch. Okay, one who makes the laws. It makes laws for the whole country. Legislative makes the laws for the whole country. It consists of two houses, one is Rajya Sabha and another is Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. So what does Parliament do? Parliament is a legislative council, legislative branch. Okay, it makes laws. Then it has two houses, one is Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Okay? Whatever the meetings are held in the parliament house only. Okay, whatever the meetings will be done in the benefit of the nation, it would be held in the parliament house only. Now we are going to learn about the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. The Lok Sabha is the lower house of a parliament. So Lok Sabha is the lower house, okay? It is the lower house of the parliament. The members of Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people for a period of 5 years. We'll have elections, right? For the 5 years election we'll have, no? This Lok Sabha people, the members of Lok Sabha is elected by us only, by the people only for the term for 5 years. We will only elect them, okay? Then therefore, They are called the House of People. Lok Sabha is called the House of People. Lok means what, children? People. Lok means what? People in Hindi. Lok means people. People, we all are the people, okay? The speaker ensures the smooth proceeding of the house. Here you can see in the picture. Everyone will start to have their meetings in the Lok Sabha. They will give their opinions on anything. And speaker will be the head there. Speaker should listen. Speaker means what? He should listen and speak about it. He will listen and everything. And his speaker is the head, like head type. Okay. And he should make sure everything will go on smoothly, properly. No fightings, no disputes, nothing. It should go properly. Any citizen in India above 25 years of age can contest elections for the Lok Sabha. About 25 years. For voting, it is above 18 years. If they want to become a member of Lok Sabha, they should be 25 years of age or above 25 years of age. Below 25, they can't be the member of Lok Sabha. Okay? Voting can be done, general election voting can be done at the age of 18. To ensure that electronic elections are fair, the country has been divided into constituencies. So, election should be in every ward. So, you know, you are this ward, that ward during election time. So that election should be fair, election should be, every citizen has to get their right of election. So that they made the constituencies. These constituencies are, they will perform their act only in the election time, okay? They will come, you have seen, right? They used to come to near the houses and they used to give a slip for the election purpose and all, okay? There are 543 constituencies in our constituencies. Candidates from several political parties stand for election from each constituency. We have many parties. Each party's candidates will stand for the election. Okay. The candidate who gets the most votes is declared as the elected from that constituency. So candidates will having the people whom we will celebrate elect for the MLA purpose or MLC purpose for whom we will elect, they will become the elected member of that constituency. That party will be winning. The Lok Sabha can have a maximum strength of 552 members, of which 530 members represent the state. So, Lok Sabha can have 552 members, of which 530 members represent the state. Okay, they can have 552 members. In that, 550 members should be from that particular state. And 20 members represent the union territories. Okay? So, Lok Sabha will be having 552 members. In that, 550 members should be from the state. And 20 members can be from the union territories. Okay? This 550 members will be from the 28 states. And this 20 members will be from the union territories. 8 union territories. And 2 members representing the Anglo-Indian community are nominated by the president. So 2 members will be representing by the Anglo-Indian community, nominating by the president. Okay. 2 members representing the Anglo-Indian community. Anglo-Indian means children, they are mixed from the Britishers and the Europeans and Indians. Okay, they are Anglo mixed from the Britishers as well as the Indians. There will be mixed Britishers and Indians from the paternal line, from the father's line. Okay. Then, this was about the Lok Sabha. Now, next we have Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha is the upper house of a parliament. The members of Rajya Sabha are not elected directly by the people of India. Instead, they are elected by the members of state legislative assemblies for a period of 6 years. It is therefore also called the Council of States. So, Lok Sabha members, we will elect for the term for 5 years. But Rajya Sabha members, we won't elect. Okay, they are being directly elected by the legislative assemblies, state legislative assemblies. The term will be in the MLA constitution and about the states, they will elect the people of Rajya Sabha. So only they are called as Council of States. Okay, Rajya Sabha is called as Council of States. Rajya, states, Sabha, council, Lok, people, Sabha, council. Lok means for people. We, people, Rajya, states. There only you can get the names, children. Okay? And this will be the Rajya Sabha will be a period term of 6 years. Rajya Sabha is presided over the Vice President of India. So, who is presided by Rajya Sabha? By the Vice President of India. It has maximum strength of 250 members, of which 238 are elected and 12 are nominated by the president. So how many members are there in Rajya Sabha? There are totally 250 members. In which how many are nominated by the president? Of which 238 are elected. 238 are elected and 12 are nominated by president. members are being elected. In the 12 members will be nominated by the president itself. 1/3 of the members retires every 2 years, so the Rajya Sabha is a permanent house unlike the Lok Sabha. So Rajya Sabha is a permanent house as well as upper house. So 2/3 of the members will be retiring, okay? 1/3 of the members will be retired for every 2 years. So 1/3 means most probably 1/4 below. They will be retiring every 2 years. So only it is the upper house of the permanent house of the parliament. Okay, children. So till here I have completed. I have done about the central government, the parliament, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Everyone go through this. If any doubts, you will definitely meet with our interactive session. Okay, children. Bye-bye everyone and take care.